You've been working on your due diligence evaluation and selection project, and you've selected your shortlist of solutions based on your requirement and your RFI. Now you want to evaluate how the vendor and implementation partners can deliver what you're looking for. So this is referred to as the commercial phase or the selection phase. Regardless of whether you have a formal or informal RFP process, you want to include the following 12 sections in your request. So it starts with the introduction. This is the request about your current scenario, objectives, proposal process, format, timeline, contact information, and how the RFP will be scored. The next section is the demonstration scripts. These are scripts that are handed to the vendors and implementation partners for them to give comparable presentations about your key use cases. It includes the guideline and the expectation. The next section is the data center architecture, information about location, equipment, security, backup, and disaster recovery. The data storage section is about data management, transfer, data migration, integration, and interfaces. The proposed services section is about the statement of work, the implementation plan, the training plan, and other service level agreements. The proposed support level section is about how support will happen after go live. And the pricing section, also referred to as the RFQ or request for quotation, is the detailed pricing that would make up the total cost of ownership for the next 3 or 5 years. The vendor viability section is a focus on the vendor and includes information like their financial information, the roadmap, their customer base. The implementation partner viability section is about the strategy and experience of the implementation partners. It includes key information about qualifications of their key personnel and relevant project experience. The reference check section is about the vendor and implementation partner reference checks. And the terms and conditions section is about the contract terms and conditions, as well as the payment terms. And the final section is about the selection process and next steps. The value of this type of approach is to create a very healthy competitive environment where you force the vendors and implementation partners to provide information and best price in a uniform and comparable format. If you'd like to find out more information, please contact us.